My name is JP McEvenew. I'm the Executive Director of Roofing Operations for Semper Solaris. Some customers may be interested to know about the technological advances within the roofing industry, one of which is the movement towards using cool roofs or cool roofing products. In fact, most building jurisdictions in California are requiring or mandating that you install a cool roof. So, what is a cool roof? Requirements for a cool roof are generally based on the Solar Reflective Index, or SRI. SRI value gives an indication of how hot a material is likely to become in the sun. So, the lower the SRI, the hotter it's likely to become. The higher the SRI, the more reflective or cooler it would become in the sun. So, when talking about cool roofs, it goes without saying that color is important. A lighter roof is going to be cooler than, say, a darker roof. In fact, according to the Department of Energy's website, a black roof will be about 50 degrees hotter than a cool roof, which may only reach 100 degrees in the sunshine. With that being said, through the development of different types of granules that are embedded in the roof shingles themselves, we're actually able to make darker roofs that meet the Solar Reflective Index, SRI, values required to be cool roofs. That means now you can get your black roofs, your brown roofs, dark gray, and they can still meet that Solar Reflective Index needed to be installed in your building jurisdiction. Why is this important? Well, some benefits of using a cool roof or a cool roof product are less heat is going to transfer inside the building. This also reduces the amount of heat that's transferred to the outside air, which has a positive effect on our environment. A cooler roof ultimately means a more energy efficient home for you and your family. Another major shift in the roofing industry has been the movement towards using synthetic underlayments. The underlayment is the water barrier that goes below the shingles or the tile. It's really that last line of defense should water get underneath the shingles or the tile. Traditionally, this has been an organic material. So it's been a felt paper or fabric that's soaked in asphalt. More and more nowadays, manufacturers and roofing installers alike are moving towards a high-performance synthetic product. Some of the benefits of this advancement in technology are synthetic underlayments tend to lay flatter for a more uniform working surface and more consistent final product. Synthetic underlayments have a longer exposed lifespan. Most traditional felts will carry a 3-month exposure before they need to be replaced. A synthetic underlayment has a 6-month exposure, particularly beneficial in new construction applications where a roof may have underlayment on it, roof paper, for several months before the builders are ready to have the actual final roofing product installed. A synthetic underlayment is lighter than a traditional underlayment, which means it's easier for the guys who are installing to work with the product. Probably most important is that synthetics are produced by the shingle manufacturers today, meaning we're not using a third-party product, we're not using something that doesn't jive with their warranties. It is an integral part of the manufacturer's roofing system. Hopefully now you can see that a roof is more than just a shingle or a tile. It's a system of components that are working together to really protect your home from the elements and ultimately give you peace of mind that your home is protected.